Should we ride in formation, boys?
Sure.
Why not?
Now, what manipulation?
Manipulation and driving.
All right.
Since we're on an agent from harm. Next upgrade, I need to put another point in manipulation, I think.
Are all to die the same color? That's weird. Yay, I didn't crash.
My god! Dax falls off his butt!
Dax, you know, you're never going to be able to beat that speed through time.
Actually, no. Dax's bike falls on his leg and hurts. He's like,
not going to roll any willpower for that.
That's all black.
I'm running perfectly.
I didn't fall off, I don't guess, but I'm pretty wobbly.
Yes, Dax is going to spend 2 willpower points to.
so he doesn't. Yeah. Okay.
There you go. He recovered.
Oh, yeah. Okay. Dax, somehow, he looks like almost as if he's going to fall, but then all of a sudden he pulls off a crit move, and now all of a sudden he looks really cool as he's here. Like, oh, sorry.
I was going to say that you meant to do that, Dax.
No. A good man can admit whenever he makes a mistake, but I recovered from that mistake, so hey, let's keep going.
The sticker is kind of wobbling in the back.
He's controlling his inner rage from talking to a cop, and it's just coming out now. It's wobbling the bike.
I might still be a little high.
Piggy, you need to. I mind speak to him. Piggy, you need to retard your anger there.
Who are you calling a retard?
Okay, you guys are driving down the highway.
Nothing.
You're not out. You guys aren't really raising suspicion because I assume, well, Dax is leading the herd. He's not having you guys go over the speed limit or anything like that. So he's just driving to look cool, not for speed.
No, man, you drive for speed.
That's what I said.
So, you should run into that guy. He's in a biker bar at some point.
Shoot him.
So we can shoot him.
Got him.
That guy pops in the middle of the highway. You don't ride a bike to look cool, you ride it for speed.
Dax runs him over.
Now, just to shoot out his fucking Kawasaki or whatever the fuck he is. Fuck you and your rice burn. Pow.
Alright, you guys get to about the point where you see a turnoff road and a big sign that says Pansea Pharmaceuticals. I know that's not where you're going, but you do see this sign.
Should we go there?
Clues. Yeah, I've got a hunch. We should probably turn this way. My detective skills.
I thought you were going there
to go to the warehouse.
Well, we wanted to just look at, just get a visual glimpse of the factory.
All right.
Okay. All right. So, I guess Dax makes a left into there, and actually, it would be right. Excuse me. Yeah, he makes a right to the driveway thing. And
he can't turn. Right. He can't turn left.
He's on an ambi-turner.
He's not an ambi-turner.
Alright, he leads you guys up the way. You guys drive about 4 or 5 minutes or something like that. It's kind of a forested area. There's some coverage, but at the same time, I mean, do any of you guys have sense worm?
Yes.
Come on, Silent Strider, it's like a standard gift for us.
I added it last time.
You, I'm not gonna make you roll for it because it's not warm yet, but it's definite uneasiness. You know, you feel like a spiritual imbalance or something like that.
There's an imbalance to the force here.
Let's get my crossbow lightsaber.
It's like a million voices cried out in silence, or cried out in terror, or something, and we're suddenly silenced.
That's when we blew up the house. That's when we blew up the meth.
Hmm.
A thousand tweakers suddenly yelled out.
I have a bad feeling about this.
Yeah, Dax is like, oh, I don't feel too comfortable about this place either. Wow. All
right, so I have sense prey, but not sense worm.
Sense prey?
Yeah.
Alright, don't get too cocky, kid.
Are you just saying?
No, I'm just saying that I have.
I thought that was a gift for a second. I was like, wow.
Yeah, it is a gift. According to this sheet that you gave me.
It is?
Sense prey, yeah.
So if you drive by a church during like mass, you'd like ding off you.
It's P-R-E.
Oh.
So when you drive by a cattle farm, it goes off.
Wow. What's it under?
Is it a ranch?
Yeah.
You wrote
put
this.
It on there, Brett. Jesus.
Yeah, sense of the prey.
Rank one.
Oh, no. You can't use that because you don't. You need to use that to track somebody down.
Oh, that's specific.
And, you got to know something about the person you're trying to track down. You don't have anybody in specific that you're trying to track down here.
Yeah. Or if you're out hunting, you can use it to track.
Yeah.
Not
so, no, you can't use sense of the prey.
Track regular prey or the most dangerous game. Either it works. Mm-hmm.
Alright, yeah, you're driving for a few minutes, and eventually you see about two cars in front of you, and a closed fence gate with a barbed wire top on it, and you see a gatehouse. With a man with a clipboard outside who's now eyeballing you, bikers who are driving up here on your motorcycle.
Alright, we're going to slow down and turn around. It's like, oh, looked wrong.
Yeah.
Kind of like, went the wrong way. And then, try to see as much
Oops.
As I can.
Oopsie.
But before I turn around, I'm going to do how much I can see before I turn around.
All right, at a quick glance, to turn your bike around, let's see here, from this gate, you see you see the fence with the barbed wire top, you see a tall corporate office building that looks like it houses several offices, and you see a large building off to the very first building you see is a very large building with some smoke coming out of the top. Looks like a possible factory of some sort. And then right next to it, which would be this way, would be on the left of it, you see a tall office looking building. And of course you see guards. Well, you see one guard with a clipboard and another guard in the gatehouse. And you do see what looks like a wandering guard riding around on a cushman. And you see several cars in the parking lot because it's daytime. And make a perception and alertness check. Difficulty 8.
All of us or just him?
Well, he's the only one that's looking, so.
Oh. Well, I'm looking too.
Oh, okay.
I'll look as well.
We're all looking. Six.
Yeah, I got a 9.
All right, you notice, like, Derek?
Yeah, I got it. I got a 9.
Yeah, Alan has no idea.
He's staring at the sun.
He's gritting his teeth going, cops, cops.
You see what looks like a camera that is pointing down towards the cars that are coming in, and looks like it's monitoring everything. Newfangled technology.
CCTV. Yeah, they have CCTV right about them.
It's for the, you know, the richer companies, yes, but I mean, everyday companies, no, would not have had this, huh?
Yeah, they have CCTV.
Some, but I mean, not on such a widespread, you know,
yeah, like
that
the,
it is.
Like the seven, like the gas stations didn't have it, like,
yeah.
None of them would have had it back then, but yeah, this kind of company would have had it.
Yeah.
And beta tape, you know, friggin' beta tapes and gigantic things. All right.
Yeah.
You guys see that? Yeah, they got cameras. Fancy, fancy.
Wow, it's
No, Piggy, stop staring at the sun.
Bring your eyes out. Leave the green room.
Zoom. Vroom, vroom, vroom.
Okay.
I wave at the guard with a clipboard.
He waves back at you, but gives you a peculiar eye.
Well, if they're working with the M&Ms and they just saw us, then our cover's probably blown. FYI, guys.
Maybe they think we're the M&Ms.
I don't know if we're close enough to make out what our chances were. But assume the worst.
I always assume the worst.
That's why I'm still here.
So keep your eyes peeled on the road, guys. We might get some company.
All okay. Right, so down the road to the warehouse.
Is that where you guys are going next?
Yes.
Yeah.
Sure. You head down towards the warehouse. You're driving for a few miles. Let's do
random encounters. Hooray.
It is clear and smooth sailing all the way down to the warehouse. You get to what looks like a pretty large sized building. It's got a fairly good sized parking lot, but I mean, it looks like it's more for big trucks than small cars or something like that. But you see about three small cars outside, along with two big trucks. You see one guy standing by the front door. Looks like he's a guard. He's wearing a blue outfit.
Regular security.
Yep.
Don't see any bikes.
No bikes. No.
What's the layout like? Is there just a driveway up to the front?
Yeah. Yeah, just a small driveway up to the front. It turns right off from the highway. But, yeah, this is a small driveway leading to a fairly good-sized parking lot. But, yeah, like I said, the parking lot looks like it's mainly for large vehicles and it is for small.
Now, what's the dimensions on their warehouse? How big is it?
About the size of half a football
field. Okay, not too big, then.
Not real big.
Not too huge, but big enough to store some stuff, yes.
Is it one story?
What's that?
Is it one story?
It looks like, guesstimate.
It's pretty easy to see if it's one or two.
Well, it's a one floor, but it's got a high ceiling, you know, so
okay.
I think of stories as in, you know, levels.
Multiple
of
floors.
Like, yeah, above, yeah. High, is it like a, looks like a high ceiling, about two stories, the equivalent of two or how many stories?
About three stories, yeah, the high
okay.
ceiling.
So it stacks high.
Yeah.
Okay.
That makes sense.
And there's windows like more up towards the top of the warehouse, but there's hardly any towards the bottom of the warehouse. So it looks like they rely upon maybe natural light here in the day or something like that for their operations. Or, well, I mean, of course they'll have some electrical light.
So we made a 3-story, 50-yard wide. How many yards? How much width?
50 by 50. Hey, I'm making up this warehouse as we speak.
It's one of those modern jobs.
Yes, a perfect square. 50 by 50 yards. All right, 3 stories tall. See one guard. Not a lot of activity going on at the moment. Surroundings, it got any kind of fencing on it, or is it just kind of open?
Oh! Said no. No fence. See the security. You see a man in a blue uniform standing in front of a door.
All right, guys. Let's take a different route back to the clubhouse. Like I said, I think, you know, good chance we might have whatever's left of the M&Ms looking for us, since the guards at the main place saw us. Take some back roads back, and I think I've got an idea. We'll talk about it. Everybody.
All right, let's go then.
All right. Brr, brr, brr. Okay, you're back in the club.
that 10 fucking worked out good for us.
I did not intend on any attacks outside the compound, so I just let that whole thing slide.
Just keeping.
I know.
So we don't know if they made out what cup to were, if they knew what they meant, or maybe they just thought we were M&Ms. I mean, we don't know.
Yeah. Well,
we were still pretty far away. So, but you know, they had a guard that had any fucking brains in him. You could have been like, hey, that's not the M&Ms cut. Hey, that's another banker gang. Let's call them. Could have.
I also thought that though they subcard.
Understandable, but also I'm trying to move this along faster, at a faster rate, because, you know, like, you guys have been in Oakland for a long time, so.
Yeah.
Moving right along.
Footloose and fancy free.
Mm-hmm. Bear left.
Right, frog.
On the bear's natural habitat. Let's do the bear.
Is that where the bears seen bears, bro?
Muppet movie reference. Jesus.
I haven't seen that in forever. Hey, a movie starring everybody and me.
Right, back at the clubhouse. Waiting on Mitchell to contact.
All right, you guys get back at the clubhouse like. An hour passes, and Mitchell pulls up, and he goes, well, I had to pull a few strings down there, but I was able to get you somewhat of a blueprint here. He hands you the map. I did not draw this damn map out. It's basically a large map of... I drew this map out on paper. I didn't draw this out on the computer.
You can sketch it on the website.
Yeah.
Oh no, yeah, we got the little little drawy thing here. Freehand, yeah. Go click on the brush and go to freehand. Let's do like a quick thumbnail sketch.
There may be some extra lines on there. No. I can't figure out how to do the erase button.
I see a line. I see a blue line. Is that the thin blue line? Is that the chubby blue line?
That is the chubby blue line.
Oh, crap. Sorry, I'm drawing things too. I didn't mean to.
Stop drawing. You're just going to draw kill all pigs.
How do you... Race is stupid. Oh well. I did not want that to. What? No!
Just banana.
This is worth it. Just
how do I undo this?
Let's see.
If you want to draw a square, it has draw shape.
No, it's a circle. It's kind of like an oval-ish.
It's like a
thing.
Banana.
Or a taco.
I have no idea how to clear that.
Damn it! That's not it.
We can pretend that's a square. Is that the entire area, or is that the building supposed to be?
Here, I'll try to improvise something.
It's your first time. We can just cuddle, Brett.
Okay. That is the perimeter.
So the straight line is the front of the building.
No,
the house was a square.
That is what you saw was the corporate building.
Okay, is the long line the road?
What's that?
It's a straight line, the road.
What straight line? This straight line?
There's a building.
The rectangle.
That straight line is absolutely nothing. I was trying to draw a fucking circle, and that damn straight line came off like that. If I could erase that fucking straight line, I would. God damn it.
He gave me recording this.
Yeah, it's recording.
Anytime the grid is enabled in page sitting, snap to grid is enforced on the tabletop.
Yeah, if I put this on the YouTube, I'll screenshot this once we've done.
This is not exactly to scale here.
Looks like a happy face. Yay, meth. It actually kind of looks like Ratchet, which makes sense. It's pharmaceuticals. Those are the factory building?
All right, this rectangular building that is going in a horizontal fashion is the building that you saw the smoke coming out of the top of it. The rectangular building that's going, no, I'm sorry, that would be vertical. The vertical one is the one that you saw the smoke coming out of it. The horizontal one is the one is marked for a type of security and storage, and the squarish one is the corporate office. It's surrounded by a large fence. This here is a parking lot. And this here is a commercial parking lot. And you'd find the blueprints that lead to, or that mention a waste dump that is coming out of this little hole. Waste is being, let's say, drained out of the company in a very large fashion through this hole in the back of the company.
Wow, that looks like a back door in.
The waste.
Through the worm waste, yeah.
That sounds super appealing.
Hey, you only took a shower today. I'm sure you'll manage. It still looks very happy. The picture of
it kind of looks like Ratchet.
I don't see it.
Top of the square kind of like go out.
If you're being real generous, okay, sure.
He's got a giant mole on his right cheek.
Or a zit.
And a scar.
Oh, that's his butt.
Okay, so the top rectangle, top horizontal rectangle, is the one with smoke coming out of it?
Yes. And on the front part of that, those are bay doors. And there's a bay door on the side of that. There are smaller doors here. There you go. There's one door.
Oh, that one's
there's
the one
another door.
Okay, that one of the
two office doors here.
So, which one was the main square warehouse?
The rectangle that's going horizontal.
Okay.
That's it. That's marked for as secured storage.
Okay.
Okay, so we're looking at all this in the clubhouse, I'm assuming, right?
Yes.
That waste area does look like a way in. It's probably going to be...
Cosmo is like shaking his head. Man, I don't know about going through a waste area of a possible company like this, man.
Yeah, that'd be bad for a lot of reasons.
We gotta clean it up sometime, I realize, but not the... If we could find a cleaner way in, I'm for that, man.
Come on, you can kill the most banes going that way.
True.
Got a grenade launcher? Hey, Gargon, do you have a grenade launcher?
I could get one, sure. Well, what do you want to use it for?
You don't want to use a grenade launcher, right? A pharmaceutical's ass, do you?
Well, I'm thinking, you know, if we don't get people inside first and we're just doing an outside assault, we'll just do something to create a lot of havoc. Someone just kind of run around just throwing grenades and creating chaos. Like, just launching grenades.
Okay. I think that caused a scene.
I didn't think we were... Well, I wasn't planning on going stealth on this.
Oh, okay.
It's up to you. What do you guys think?
I think whatever we do, we should do at night. If
frontal,
we do it...
frontal assault or...
I try to sneak in. There's probably a lot of security there, and they probably have prepared for assaults of people of our nature.
I'm not worrying about the depot warehouse. Go for the source.
Well, which one probably has more security?
This one does, by far.
Okay.
We should go after the depot for now.
Yeah. Go after the source, and then once we've got it cleared out, we can check out the warehouse.
I would love to go to the corporate building and check out the labs, but that's probably not feasible.
Right, does anyone see any way in besides the waste area?
Dax goes. I got a suggestion. We did notice that the warehouse had very lax security and trucks there.
Why don't we just get a truck and go in?
Wow.
Hey, Mitchell, do you think the police have access to a truck that looks like what's it, they do delivery to this place?
Or we could just camp out for the warehouse and get the truck once they get away from the warehouse. Hijack the truck and then go in.
I guess we could do that, yes.
So
that could be a way in.
So once the truck's leaving the warehouse, we hijack it and then turn right back around and take the same truck back in?
I'd say we try to find a truck that's on its way to the warehouse.
Oh, that makes more sense.
Hey, did we steal any cuts from the M&Ms?
I did.
Yeah, yeah. Derek did.
We could switch out pets and we could bring bikers in as a security detail and call in the note. Don't know if they would check them, how close they would check them.
But, says Dax, we don't even know if the bikers are actually security there. No, but none of us have actually tried to broach that.
We can just put people in the back of the truck, I guess. Trojan horse name.
That could work.
Yeah, we ain't gotta worry about.
But so you think we should jack the truck as it's leaving the depot?
That'd be the best way to find the truck. I would assume. And then we don't raise security at the place by trying to get it from there.
Nah, I like the idea of trying to catch one on the way in.
Yeah, same. Because if we're gonna, they're expecting that truck, and then we can pretend to be that truck.
Be awfully suspicious if one that just left came right back.
That's what I meant. Come here from the depot. Let's get a truck from the depot.
Big Jim goes, from my experience in dealing with what I've heard of, like different corporations that Pentax uses, employees are pretty much, let's say, disposable. I bet security, while maybe tight, it may not be too surprising to see new faces.
Yeah, but he still probably would need an ID.
Would need an ID, sure.
Is there any chance we can get a fake ID done up fast enough?
Well, once we capture it, we can maybe just get some laminate and get somebody's photo. We don't know the size of the photo, though. That's the thing. It's kind of like, and if we knew the size of the photo of their badges, we could.
Can we just get a Polaroid and cut out and put it in?
Yeah, that's what I'm thinking. But we need to, we don't know the size of the photo of the badge. Who would know, like, what would be a standard size picture? Like, 1 by 2 inches, maybe?
Sure.
Sounds about it. Yeah, so whoever's driving the truck, let's get a Polaroid of them, cut it out, and then we'll hijack the truck. Just, paste the picture over the other guy's picture and see if it works. If it doesn't work, then we just fucking ram the place in. What does everyone think?
Yeah, good idea.
Alright.
Okay.
Who's driving the truck?
Who's driving the truck?
Well, which one of us looks least like could they be a most respectable looking truck driver?
Derek. I got long hair.
So does maybe, Derek, but it's in a ponytail.
Dax. No, Dax got a lot of tattoos. So far.
Well, he'll be wearing the uniform.
Cosmo looks a lot like Peter Fonda from from Easy Rider. So.
Hey, Cosmo.
Cosmo. All right, Cosmo. You got a Polaroid liner on here, Dargon?
Yeah, I think I could find one. He goes off. Man, I gotta drive a truck. Man, that's such a bummer, dude.
Sacrifices.
Yeah, I think he'll survive.
Now, is there any walls in here that are white and have a fur background?
Oh, yeah. In fact, they have a blue screen.
A blue screen?
Or a green screen. Whatever. Hey, I'm distracted because I kind of got a piss, so is any way we can take like 5 or 10?
Yeah, I'd like to take a piss too. Because... Okay.
Take 5, everybody.
Maybe 7, but I'm gonna go and take Spike out.
Yeah, go walk Spike.
Alright.